What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more acid trance. And we're going to listen to some more acid trance from 1996. I mentioned it before, arguably my favorite year for a number of genres. Again, I like music right up on into the present and all the genres that I'm thinking of, acid trance, acid techno, hardcore. But yeah, 1996 was just a really great year, and I suppose part of it is that's essentially when I began listening to electronic music and ultimately early 97 going to parties, so I'm sure there is a nostalgic factor, but I do claim as sort of objectively as possible that tunes from 96 and a lot of genres are really at kind of like peak old school creativity. So yeah, ultimately we're going to listen to a tune by Sussex, which is a name for Mark Scusi, which is not actually his real name either. It's Marcus Firman, but it's like P-F-I-R-M-A-N-N. But I think Marcus Firman, and again, he produced, I think, mostly under the name Mark Scusi, but he did release a few records under the name Sussex. I discovered Sussex through a tune that he did that's really dichotomous. It's called Sabotage. And as it turns out, the tune on the flip side of that, which I didn't even know about when I got that record, is actually even more interesting, Transatlantique. Nevertheless, Sabotage, it has this like really emotional, melodic 90s trance feel for like half the track, but there's a part, like, you know, sort of the, after the initial intro, it's very melodic, very epic, and at the end, it's very melodic, very epic, and right in the middle of the track is this crazy, hard, wicked, nasty face sort of section that sounds like it's from a totally different track, and I kind of enjoy Sabotage because it's so oddly, like, balanced. Well, this tune is sort of dichotomous, too, not quite as intensely, but it is the same light and dark contrast, but in this case, I think it actually works better with the title, because this tune is called Paranoia. So, you know, paranoia being sort of suspicious and feeling threatened by people when in many cases there's actually no reason to feel that way, even like reasons not to feel that way, but you know, you have it in your mind that you're being persecuted or whatever. So the main kind of acid riff and the like larger section or sections of the tune does have this very nervous, oh my gosh, there's dangerous things happening and I'm under threat. It does have a very paranoid type of feel. But it's contrasted with these breakdowns, there's two of them I think, which are very sort of soft and light, and it's like you're walking through a meadow on a bright sunny day and there's this green livery all around you. So yeah, I'm not quite sure how he came upon this idea of sort of balancing these tracks with like very different parts. But this, and as I said, Sabotage is another great example. Are you coming up here? Oh, look who's coming up, it's Luca. So yeah, I do want to mention one thing also. I have two copies of this record, and I think part of it is just because I eventually realized that my first copy just had a bit of surface noise and scratches here and there, and so when I got the second one, I literally wrote on there, good copy, which is, you know, it may seem like, oh, but you've defaced the sleeve, whatever. It's like, well, I'm not planning on selling this anytime soon, and again, when you're a DJ who does have multiple copies of a record, it's very helpful to sort of have a shorthand like that where it's like, is it, nope, this isn't the good one? Okay, this is the good one. Now, admittedly, because I play this one almost exclusively now, you wonder, over time, maybe it'll end up getting enough pops and scratches and so on that, like, will this actually be true anymore? Whatever, these are all the weird concerns of a DJ, but let's get it. This is Mark Scusi, or rather Marcus Firman as Sussex, and the track is called Paranoia. Apologies for this big fluff ball on the stylus. Maybe 45? Thank you. clouds scattered, sun coming through. Tends to happen more, like beginning and the end of records, of tracks on records, tend to get more surface noise because it's where like the needle is like put down and picked up the most, and ultimately the outside edge especially is where people grab it the most. Sometimes people actually do hold it by the inside. Either way, it's still, I think, the better copy, but I do think it's also getting to the point where now, you know, I may have to switch the sleeves at some point, or switch the records in the sleeves. Nevertheless, I do enjoy that tune. The other track on this side, or on this record, what is it? World of Music, I don't think it's quite as good as United Elements of Music, which again is another tune that he puts out, but under his other alias, Mark Scusi. But it is a decent track. We might come back for that one. But I think before we do that, and if I haven't done it already, maybe I have. Again, you know, the Trance and Techno Reactions like go back to almost a year ago now. And, you know, I do a lot of reactions. So over time, I don't actually remember sometimes if I've done one of the Trance or Techno ones before. But if I haven't done it, I'll get to that one soon. If I have done it, I'll like put a link to it in the comments. But yeah, basically an interesting artist, don't have a whole lot by him, don't think he was ever, like, seen on the same level as, you know, a lot of the heavyweights in terms of acid trance and hard trance, Nostrum, Kai Tracid, you know, Kors, Papa Gargano, and so on, you know, Nuclear Hyde or Steinmeier. But ultimately, I do enjoy the tunes from him, I know. I'm gonna come back at some point and react to United Elements of Music because it has that Annie Lennox slash Eurythmics sample in it. But yeah, ultimately, let me know what you think of this one. And Luca and I, if I can get her off my lap comfortably, we'll see you next time. Peace. There she goes. She's off.